One really key thing that helped me break into iOS development was to attend a coding bootcamp. So in this video, I'm gonna break down my top things to consider when trying to decide if a coding bootcamp is right for you. Welcome to my channel. My name is Dave and I make weekly videos about the field of iOS development and how to break in. Some of the worst mistakes that I've seen from people who attend bootcamps are that they don't even bother to start learning software development ahead of time. Then when they get to the bootcamp, they realize that they really don't actually like it. Or they approach it with very unrealistic expectations about how quickly and easily they'll be able to land a job. And then when those expectations aren't met, they're left in a bad situation. So my goal in this video is to help you avoid making those mistakes and help uncover if a bootcamp truly is the right move for you. I touched on this in a previous video, but it's worth repeating that a bootcamp is not for someone who's just looking for a quick and easy way to score a high-paying job. For one, bootcamps are very challenging and very intense, and two, it's taking most people a while after graduating their bootcamp to land their first job due to the decrease in demand for junior-level developers. I was told by a bunch of people beforehand that doing a bootcamp is not going to guarantee that you're going to land a job, and I think that's a really important message that can sometimes get lost today when you're only hearing about these success stories. Now, starting with my first point of who a bootcamp is right for, is somebody who's put in at least 100 hours of learning software development and still enjoys it. Pre-bootcamp, you want to make sure that it's worth the investment of your time and money. So if you've been learning iOS or whatever area that you're interested in for several months ahead of time, you'll have much more clarity on if software is really an area that you could see yourself having a fulfilling career for the next 5 to 10 years before you get locked into anything. For reference, I was averaging about 7 hours a week for 4 months straight before I had come to the conclusion that I really wanted to pursue iOS as a career. And that's also not including the 70 hours of pre-course work and additional learning I did after I was enrolled in the bootcamp. If you think about it, there's really not any downside to doing this. And so after you put in some serious time learning, either one, you'll determine that you don't have a passion for it, and now you've saved yourself a bunch of time and money, or two, you'll know that you really like it and have now further confirmation that this is something that you should be pursuing. And you'll also have built up a lot of the initial skills that will give you a huge head start if you actually decide to do a bootcamp. In my case, going to a bootcamp meant that I had to quit my job and spend time away from my wife and friends. And so it wasn't something that I took lightly, and so my approach was that failure is not an option, and I was gonna do whatever it took to make this thing work. And so for anybody else who is approaching this decision seriously and trying to maximize your chances of success, 100 hours is not that big of an ask, you can do it. If you're not sure where to start, my last video was all about my top resources for new iOS developers, and you can find the link to that video in the description. One thing I really love about software development is that the barrier to entry is a lot lower than some other higher paying fields. But even so, it's really important to understand my next point, which is to make sure that you weigh the full cost a bootcamp may be on both your time and your money. I don't have the exact stats for right now, but when I attended my bootcamp right before COVID had hit, they had said to expect to be searching for a job for about 6 months long. And now with COVID, I think that 6 to 10 months is probably a lot more realistic of a time frame. And so if you're not able to be searching for a job for that amount of time, then attending a bootcamp might be a risky approach for you. And then in terms of the cost, I think that a lot of people just look at the tuition of, let's say, $10,000 and then stop there. But if you're doing a full-time bootcamp, which is something I would recommend, then that program is probably gonna last about 3 months long. And so that's 3 months that you could have been earning income at your current job if you do have one. And so let's say you're making $60,000 a year, that's $5,000 every single month in lost income. And so by the time that you're leaving a three-month program, it would have actually cost you $25,000. And then if you're really lucky and land a job within 6 months of really hard work applying and advancing your skills, that's another $30,000 that it's costing you in lost income versus if you had just kept your same job. I'm not trying to say this to scare anyone necessarily. I more just want to offer a different perspective on things and really encourage you to think about what it is that you're getting into. And if logistically for you, a bootcamp just isn't a possibility, then full self-taught is maybe the only option for you, which people have done. But I think that for a lot of people, it's a lot harder to succeed that way. And the pace at which you acquire the skills needed is probably going to be a lot slower than a reputable program that has taught hundreds of students and has instructors there to help you. And that brings me to my last point here, which is once you know, just go. It's my belief that if you know you want to do iOS and you don't have a formal background in computer science or programming, that a software bootcamp is the right way to break in 2021. For me, I had confirmed that I really enjoyed iOS by spending over 100 hours learning online. And I was also fortunate enough to be in a situation where I could afford the upfront cost and then just live cheaply on my wife's salary afterwards while I was trying to land a job. And so while aspects were still, you know, scary or unknown, there was really nothing that was holding me back. And so I knew that the longer I waited to actually jump, the harder that it was going to be. So again, if you have put in the work upfront and still really enjoy iOS and you're not going to be putting yourself in a bad spot financially, even if it takes you 6 to 10 months to land a job, then I encourage you just to make the jump. The worst case scenario is that after the bootcamp, you decide that you don't want to pursue it anymore and you just re-enter the industry that you came from. But the best case scenario is that you really love it, you put in a ton of hard work, and you land a job in a growing industry that has some decent salary potential, as well as the opportunity to work on some really meaningful projects over the course of your career. I really only have good insight into DevMountain's iOS bootcamp, which is the one that I attended, and I do highly recommend it. But if there are other ones that you're interested in, see if you can connect with graduates or either current students of that program and start talking to admissions to help narrow down which one seems to be the best fit. And then once you enroll, prepare as much as you can beforehand and definitely complete all of the pre-coursework. It seems kind of like a no-brainer, but you'd actually be surprised how many people don't do it. And at least in my cohort, the people that didn't do the pre-coursework were a lot more likely to fall behind during the actual course. And once you do, it's really challenging to get caught back up. In closing, I just want to encourage you to confirm that there's at least some level of passion for software development in advance. Have a plan, do your research, and prepare. And if you've made it this far, you're maybe somewhat interested in attending an iOS bootcamp. So I really wish you success in determining what is best for you. And if you have any questions about iOS bootcamps, let me know in the comments. And then my next video is going to be a review of DevMountain's iOS program. So if you want to see that and more iOS content, subscribe to the channel. And if you want to let me know you got any value from watching this, hit the like button and I'll catch you in the next video.